Now, the topic for today is examination, the best measure for a child's competence. Year 5 will be opposing the motion, while year 6 will be supporting the motion. So, panel of judges, are you ready for us? Okay, let's hold on. I think you should start by introducing yourself, please. I've done that, but you can just introduce yourself while we're waiting for our panel of judges.
My name is Chikobu Ashore. I'm a colleague.
Please, you need to be audible. We need to hear you.
Emeka,
we need to hear you. Please
be very audible for the camera sake, please.
Okay, thank you very much. Panel of judges, they are ready. So we start with our chief speaker from year 5. You can start now.
Good day. Good day, panel of judges, accurate timekeepers, co-debaters, and my fellow distinguished people. My name is Chike Mekasimoni, a pupil in year 5. I scored to oppose the motion which states that examination is the best way to test a child's competence. First, let us define the meaning of examination. Examination is the test of a person's knowledge, while competence is the ability of an individual to do something successfully or efficiently. It means that someone can have the competence to do something, but not able to do another thing with the same competence. Bill Gates, for instance, failed his college examination, but turned out to be a business wizard and the richest man in the world today. Point one, the nature in examination. The nature in examination makes it unsuitable to test competence. Take the case where they are giving multi-choice questions. A child who knows nothing about the subject can purely pass the exam through guesswork, inability to express oneself. A child who has inability to express him or herself can get low marks in their exam, especially in oral examination. Illegible handwriting. People who have illegible handwriting fail exams. Example, I had a friend who failed his exam, not because he didn't know the answer, but because his handwriting wasn't legible. Lastly, exposure. The kind of people that a child is exposed to can affect examination. Example, a child whose mom was a petit trainer was asked 100 plus 200. He couldn't answer. But when he was asked 100 naira plus 200 naira, he quickly said 300 naira. I hope with this following point, I'll be able to convince and not confuse you that examination is clearly not the best way to test a child's competence. Thank you.
Good day, everyone. My co-debaters, panel of judges, and my accurate timekeeper. My name is Darasimi Ayokoi, and I'm here to support the motion which says examination is the best measure of the child's competence. First of all, let me start by defining what is examination competence. What is examination? Examination is the process of imparting knowledge and skill. What is competence? Competence is the qualification of being qualified. Now, I'm here to support the motion with the following points. Point one, it helps the teacher to know maybe the child is competent in the class. Point two, examination gives room of competition among the children. Point three, it helps the perfection of a child's competence. Point four, it helps the child to read more in preparation of their exam. Last but not the least, without examination, there is no promotion. Thank you. I hope with this viewpoint of mine, I'm able to convince you and not convince you that examination is the best measure of a child's competence. Thank you, and I give the light spot to Derek Magbego.
Thank you very much. Thanks, Jenna, for her. Hold on. Please, you need to be audible. They are going to assess you based on that. You need to be audible. Okay, our second speaker for year 5. Put your hands together for her. Come on.
Good day, teacher.
teachers. My name is Onama Ezewosu. I'm here to oppose the motion which says examination the best measure for a child's competence. I'm opposing this motion with all seriousness. These are my following points. Point one, there are some people who did not go to school or write exams. Meanwhile, there are some of them who went to school and wrote some exams but jumped out of school, e.g. M.K. Abiola, Mulesho Inka, Williams Brigade, and so on. Point two, examination malpractice. Examination is not the true test of a child's knowledge in the actual sense, in a situation whereby the child carries out what is called expo, meaning examination malpractice. Assuming if you call them out, they will not be able to defend themselves because they just went to the examination hall, just try the examination. Point three, in a situation whereby the parents are poor, they might not be able to put their children in school or pay for their children's school fees. Even though the children don't go to school, the children are still naturally intelligent. Point four, there are some students that cram when studying to pass the examination. If the question is asked again, the answer will be almost forgotten. Point five, the computer that have the grades might be having some problems or might be bad on their own. My fellow teachers, friends, panel of judges, and my co-debaters, I want to believe that you join me and my colleagues in opposing the motion which says examination the best measure for a child's competence. Thank you.
Thank you, Jennifer. Thank you very much, ladies. You've done well. Now, I'm going to introduce the second speaker from year six, Derek. Put your hands together for me.
Good day, everyone, my co-debaters, panel of judges, and my honorable. My name is Derek Mabeko, and I'm here to support the motion that says examination, the best measure of a child's competence. And I'm supporting with the following points. Point one, examination is a part of school, and you go to school to study. If you want to know where you stand in your class, examination is the best way. After all, there is no use of going to school to study if there is no examination to test you. Point two, without the presence of examination, some students might become very lazy. They won't feel the importance or even the need to study. Some of them might drop out of school and they won't care about the slightest thing that concerns school. Point three, without the examination, some students won't that they have to understand a particular topic or be good at it. Point four, this not only affects students, but parents, teachers, or even the community. Some teachers will feel the need to teach a particular subject to their students or make them understand the topic. This, although it makes their work easier, teachers who are committed to teaching will be having a hard time to teach their students. Point five, some teachers will jump if they are not qualified for their jobs. This might reduce their morale or even break their ambition. And with all I've said, I've come to a conclusion that examination is the best measure of a child's competence. Thank you.
Okay, thank you very much. For year five, our last speaker for year five, put your hands together for her.
Good morning, teachers, friends, panel of judges, my co and my co debaters and my fellow colleagues. My name is Ujugo Bike, and I'm here to oppose the motion that says examination the best measure for a child's competence. Examination is not the best measure for a child's competence with the following points. Point one, most children read their books for examination purpose, and when they read their books for examination purpose, the information will not last because it will be stored in the short memory instead of the long memory. Point two, most children engage themselves in examination malpractices. So therefore, one cannot tell how competent they are. Point three. Most teachers use hard words on the children during the examination. So these children become afraid, and when these children become afraid, it affects their scores in a negative way. So with this following point, I hope I've been able to convince you to join my fellow colleagues to oppose the motion that says examination the best measure for a child's competence. Thank you.
And our last speaker from year six, Professor Chisom Azike. Hands together for you.
Good day, my panel of judges, my impartial timekeepers, my co-debaters, and my attentive audience. My name is Chisom Azike, and my co-debaters and I are here to support the motion that says, is examination the best way to measure a child's competence? Now, there are many ways to measure a child's competence, but from my point of view, examination is the best way. I'm supporting this with the following points. One, examination creates a competitive atmosphere and brings out the best in the child intellectually. Two, examination exposes the potentials in an individual, both an adult and a child. Three, just by an examination, a child can win scholarships to different parts of the world. Four, in the case of a child who is not brilliant and does not like reading, but because of examination, he or she puts effort to pass the exams. Five, through exams, a teacher can know whether all he or she has been teaching has been understood and whether the students have been paying attention in the class. Lastly, inasmuch as we know that there are many successful and competent individuals who may not have undertaken formal examinations in the course of building their careers. For example, Bill Gates, the richest man in the world, didn't complete his university education but dropped out to set up one of the most successful companies in the world. But we cannot underscore the fact that he went through some form of informal examination in his bid to remain competitive while building his business. I believe that Nigeria would be a better place if every single citizen in Nigeria could get examination efforts. My dear panelists, I hope with these few points of ours, we have been able to convince you with no doubt and not confuse you that examination is the best measure for a child's competence. Thank you.
Beautiful. Now, from year 5 and year 6, does anyone have anything to contribute to add to what they have said? Okay. Okay, I'm going to call them from year 5. Put your hands together for me. And from year 6, I will invite David Ingo.
Good day, teachers, panel of judges, accurate timekeepers, and my fellow debaters. My name is Ayodele Ayomi. I'm here to oppose the motion which says examination the best measure of a child's competence. I say no, and these are my following points. One, a student might not have prepared or is dull and copies from he or his or her fellow colleagues, and not knowingly that student might pass. Two, some students have vocational skills that remembering what they have been taught in school. Examples of vocational skills: tailoring, painting, plumbing, etc. Three, bribery. Some students' parents, they pay their teacher just to increase their grade. With these following points, I hope I've convinced you all that examination is not the best measure of a child's competence. Thank you.
Thank you very much. Now, finally, I will invite David Ingo. Put your hands together for him.
Good day, teachers, pupils, my honorable timekeeper, and my panel of judges. My name is David Ibok. I'm here to support the motion which says examination is the best measure for a child's competence. I will support the motion with the following points. One, it promotes competition among the students. Two, it evaluates the teacher's strategies. Three, examination tests the knowledge of the children. Teachers, may I ask this question? How will you know if the students are really paying attention in class? If their body is here but their mind is not? That is why we need examination for the competence of the child. Four, it serves as an easy tool to regularly assess the child's capability because it gives regular feedback on what they've learned throughout the classes. Finally, the fear of examination as well as repeating class due to the failure to read makes a lot of children to read and study hard. So in conclusion, I hope with these few points of mine, I've been able to convince you and not confuse you on why examination should be the best measure for a child's competence. And students, please listen to your teachers so you become greater than them in life. Thank you.